Okay, we ran into a problem on this truck, and somebody passed has put a hole in there using cutoff.
This week on Autorestomod, Jeff removes holes and then makes more holes. Be sure to like and subscribe for more great videos on classic car mods and restorations.
National Parts Depot offers quality restoration parts for Mustang, Cougar, Camaro, Firebird, Chevelle, GTO, Chevy and Ford trucks, Bronco and Thunderbirds. For quality parts in stock and delivered fast from our four warehouses nationwide, nobody beats NPD's speed and service. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free. NPD, make your dream happen.
Okay, we ran into a problem on this truck, and somebody in this vehicle past has put a hole in there using cutoff wheels. I don't know why. I don't know why they did what they did, but we have to fix it because with the vintage air system, the two heater hoses actually run out through the stock location, and in any case, it looks like trash. I mean, what they did doesn't make any sense. So what I'm going to talk about today is how to get to that point. Because right now, what we have going on, you just can't leave it like that. There's a big, huge hole in the firewall, has to be fixed. So I'm going to show you what we do in the process I go through when I'm in a position where I don't have anything to work with, but I got to have a hole there because we got things that got to go through there. So, off and running. First thing I'm going to do is take the heater box out. Okay, so we've got the heater box out of the truck. Now, the reason I've got this heater box here is because this may be the only key we have to knowing where the holes need to go on the firewall. You have to kind of look out for this kind of stuff and think about what you're working with. I don't know what exactly is going on with this system. I think both of these are supposed to be flat and level. I'm hoping that the distance is right. Now, I've gone online and actually pulled a photo of a 1968 F100 that has a firewall bare so that you can see all the stuff on the front of it. Took an image of our firewall in roughly the same position and put a tape measure from here to here to get a measurement. Took that measurement, flipped it over, and ran the measurement from the center of this to the center of the other hole. It measures out at 1 3/4. So what I've got here is a measure of 1 3/4 to the center of the hole on both of these. So I know now that I'm pretty close, that I don't have to worry about it. And I could go in and take all this bathroom caulk. I don't know how much they used on this truck, but there has to have been at least two tubes because it's everywhere. It's on the accelerator pedal. It's on the heater. It's on everything. It's all much stuff. What you can also do is the holes in the bottom of the case, and the reason I'm removing this is so you can see what I'm talking about. The holes in the bottom of the case will be more indicative of where your positions are. These should be roughly straight out across from the holes in the firewall. Ford would have done that to make this a little easier to install. So what I can do now is I can pull the caulk out. I can run a measure between the two holes. And, Jiminy Christmas, what do you know? 1 3/4 inch. So now I know that when I go in and I weld my plate in, that we can actually be sure that the other hole, the one that's completely missing on the firewall, is at 1 3/4 inch. But we got to get the plate welded in first. I'm going to show you how I went about that as well. You will go away soon for vintage air. All right, now I'm going to talk to you a little bit about the patches I do. Most of the time, I will do a butt weld patch so that it's sitting in the hole like this. Let me show you what I do. I'll use these welding arrows, I call them, or magnets, and I'll set this in here with that to make it easier on myself. And then I'll use these round magnets to set the panel flat in an area so that I can weld to it. I use typically on stuff like the things on this truck, I'm using 16 gauge sheet. You can get it down at the home improvement centers, but you can also basically get it off of an old hood or an old fender if you've got that kind of stuff laying around. I figure if you're working with a MIG welder, you probably have excess sheet metal laying around. Firewall stuff is sometimes a little thicker than the rest of the sheet metal on the car, so you might want to remember that. One thing I did on this that I try not to do is I actually have a point here on the sheet metal and the firewall. You shouldn't do that if you can get away from it, because if you have a point here, you can blow that corner off because the metal is pretty thin. I'm hoping that I can go in and tack to either side of that and then move to the center. Larry Shirley, one of the guys that has been on the show before, has basically said that if you want to, you can try to make that a rounded corner. It works a little bit better than trying to go to a square. Do the square, it's just harder to weld to sometimes. Another thing that we are trying to do is to keep a little bit of space between the patch and the panel itself. This will give me the room I need to get the wire inside the middle there. We're running a 30 wire on our system, and I can basically bounce it back and forth, and I don't have as much cleanup to do as if I'm trying to walk it over the top of it and then go in and grind the crap out of everything. That's in theory, because most of the time I can't see well enough to get in there and make that happen. Hopefully I'll get lucky today. What I'm going to do though is I'm going to hit these two corners and I'm going to move everything out of the way, move to the other side, make sure my panel is fairly flat there, and then weld those in. I'll then at some point go get some touch-up paint and paint the firewall in another case of while we're here, because basically all this crap started happening because we were going to replace the cab mount, which we haven't gotten to yet. Anyway, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get the MIG welder in here, crank it up, and get started on this so you can see kind of what I'm talking about, and move forward with the repair on this firewall. All right, now I've got my helmet on, got my gloves, got a long sleeve shirt so I don't get so distracted by all the slag whacking me in the arm. Put my welding blanket up on top of the truck a little bit to keep it from getting anything up there. Always be mindful of fire when you're working in an engine bay, because there's usually a lot of old oil on the frame rails. Slag can pop off and land on some of that stuff and cause you some issue. I've gone in and ground the edges of the plate I've inserted, and I've also ground the area around the firewall. And I've got my ground for the MIG welder, where I've opened up a spot in the paint down to the steel. I gotta work this area anyway. It's a really good spot to get a good ground off of. So now I should be able to go in and put one of my tacks in to hold this plate in place, hopefully. Now I've got a light down here. This is for me. This isn't for shooting. It's so that I can see better, because I have a little problem with my vision. I am not a good welder. I admit this freely and openly. There are people that watch our show that make fun of my welding, and I'm okay with that, because I kind of like doing it. It also frustrates me a little bit too. But what I'm doing is, with the screwdriver, I'm going in and adjusting the metal. This metal is going to warp a little bit every time you lay a daub of MIG in, and I'm hoping to be able to not have to go in and do any more pull work down here by going in and actually cutting this with the saw. I don't want to have to do that if I don't need to, because it's just more work for me to do. Most of my weld is laying up on top. We're finally getting a good solid run with this. One of the cool things, if you work with a MIG welder enough, you'll know where you need to be at. Larry can go in and basically run a weld pretty quickly and readily. It takes me a minute to get everything dialed in the way I need to have it set up. I'm going to go in and check again. The flat corner's okay. It's a little high on the sheet metal side that I've installed. I'm going to probably get a hammer here and go tap that in. We're a little low in this corner over here. What I'll do is, see, I'm going to have to go in with my saw now and open this up a little bit, because it's not wide enough for me to get my MIG wire down through that hole. All right, now I've gone in and ground this down with a wheel. Basically, I started off with a grinder. That didn't work all that well, so I went back in and I used this little bad boy right here to do some more grinding because it's got a nice coarse face on it. We'll cut those daub welds that I have down pretty readily. What happens in a case like this, with especially somebody like me welding, you're going to end up with some holes in your work. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go back in, I'm going to tack fill those holes. Now, something you could do if you were lazy and didn't want to deal with it, you could go in, use some fiberglass impregnated filler. That's some of the poly stuff that they have is really good about not pulling in moisture. You could actually fill those little voids with that stuff and be done with it and not worry about it. I'm not that kind of guy. I'm going to go in, I'm going to fill these voids up with my welds, then go back in and grind those portions down, and then should be basically done. It is nice and flat, or flat enough for what I'm doing here. This is a firewall, not an outside panel. If I were going after an outside panel, I would have worked a lot harder to get my welder tracking straight and true. We did encounter a problem with our welder, something that I had messed up when I put the spool on there. We had the spool set on a 25 reel, not the 30, so we were having misfeed problems causing it to not want to weld correctly. Hopefully now that will be worked out. But I have a light inside the cab so I can see these on the backside as well. It helps me to be able to go in and track the light and look at high spots of white in here from the light inside the truck. So I'm going to go in now, start welding this up. You've seen me weld, it sucks. We'll be back after I do that and flatten this thing out. And then I'll show you how to find or position this hole in the new panel we've got here. All right, I got my pinholes almost all filled up. There's still a couple I need to go in and clean up, but I'll get those after I get through making the hole on here because it's just long, tedious work that you have to go through. I've got my center mark, which is not the longer mark here, but it's the shorter one for this hole. And I'm going to go over from the center of this hole 1¾ inches to make the other hole. So what I want to do is I'm going to measure with my tape, and I'm not going to actually use the 1-inch mark. I'm going to go to the 11-inch mark on the line here. I'm going to hold that in place. This is going to kind of be an ish because it's really hard to get in here and see what I've got going on. So we're going to come over 1¾ inches, which is right there. And that's going to be the center line for the other hole. I'm just going to go through one more time and make sure off camera that the holes are indeed going to be in the right spot, because I want to make sure that on the box it's that way so that when I'm over here, I'm in the right spot, because I really don't want to make this patch yet again. So I'm going to go make my measurements real quick, and then I'm going to come back in and show you how to mark that up. Okay, it is at 1¾ inches. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my carpenter square here, and I'm going to go in and lay this across the bottom edge of the panel here so I can make sure that this line is going to be pretty much straight up and down. And now the hard part is going to be is I've got to go in and hit the center of that other line. I'm always bad about getting center on these holes, so wish me luck. Okay, see, that's a little high. That one right there is just about right. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to go in and dimple this and then cut my hole using a hole saw or possibly one of my Vera bits if I've got one that'll go out to that size. Now I just have to find my dimpling tool. I'm gonna use my auto punch to punch my center. I don't know why. And now you have a nice 1-inch hole where it's supposed to be on the firewall and should have been all along. And that's not the only thing I have to handle here. I still got to go in and do a huge repair on the driver's side where they thoughtfully used even more bathroom caulk and made holes that just make absolutely no sense. We still haven't figured it out. Matter of fact, in closeout, I'm going to show you the accelerator pedal and what they did with that, which is really weird. Well, that's done. Out of the way!
So, like, I'm not mad. Like that.
No, but it didn't look that good when I got started.
No.
There was glommy,
yeah, I was
bad
gonna
dude
say,
welds.
You ground on it a little bit.
Yeah.
But, like, that's making it work.
You know what's really funny is they had a GM fine thread in that hole.
Really? That's when you knew the problem was there.
No. I knew when the problem was there when I looked in through the... Because we're taking a firewall pad off for another video.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm taking a firewall pad off, and there is
a
enough...
A gigantic glob of bathroom caulk.
There's enough clear bathroom caulk over here.
Looks like someone took the tube in their hands and went...
It's like they took the back off of it and went... It was terrible, man, and it took... I was stuck.
Yeah.
It was stuck to it. I'm still just astounded.
Like, I'm,
daily, when we work on these things, I look at stuff and I go, I don't get it.
Why?
I don't get it. It doesn't make any sense.
It's like on my car, why did they cut off the kickdown linkage? What purpose? Why would you not want it?
It's like I started looking and I realized when I pulled it out that this whole plate back here,
it's not factory.
No. Mm. Somebody badly cut that out of a piece of thick sheet steel and said, good enough. And MIG welded it so badly that you couldn't get a stock screw back in the stock location anymore. I've always felt like this pedal
was
over too much this way.
Yeah.
So I'm still considering cutting this booger off right about here and welding a shaft assembly in between them so I can move the pedal over so it's closer to the brake pedal. But anyway.
Over there, you can do
the while we're here. We're getting eat up with while we're here on this truck.
It's getting bad.
It's getting scary. At least all this will be in behind the firewall pad.
Yes.
The nice new National Parts Depot firewall pad that we're working on a video on right now. There you go. I mean, it's just a little welding video to show you guys you can fix these things. Mm-hmm. Even if you don't have the other hole there on something like this, if it's something in the firewall where they've cut a huge hole in the spot, you can go out and buy a scab from another car. There's things that you can do to get around it, like we did on our F-100. Well, folks, that's our show for this week. Be sure to come back and watch us next time on Autorestomod. Y'all have a great week. So what else are we going to take off? You know what we need
while
to do?
While we're here.
I'm leaving.